The office of district elder is established to function in an effort to provide support, promote unity, and foster development among churches within our organization. District elder Red elect, do you willingly accept the responsibility that accompanies this office?
To the best of my ability, under God, I do.
Will you work in cooperation with and under the authority of the diocese to assist the local churches under your charge in meeting their ministerial objectives?
As much as lies within me, I will.
Putting your personal preferences aside, are you prepared to assist in setting conflicting matters in the best, settling conflicting matters in the best interest of the whole body of Christ?
With the help of the Lord, I am so prepared.
Will you strive to prayerfully approach the tasks that accompany this office without bias and or preconceived notions?
I will do so prayerfully.
Do you commit to represent the will of the Lord first, then the leadership in performing the miracles attached to the office or the ministries and duties attached to the office of district elder?
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I do so to you.
Ask that pastors and officials will come join us here. Scriptural context, the anointing oil represents the presence and the power of God. Whenever in the Old Testament there was an office that required ministry, it also required the anointing. The office of priest, which is that individual who speaks to God on behalf of the people, required an anointing. The office of prophet, that individual who spoke to the people on behalf of God, required anointing. And the office of king, that individual who had authority in regard to the people, required the anointing. So our brother here today, who will step into the office, multiple offices of king, priest, and prophet, will receive a symbolic anointing at this time at the hands of our Bishop Moore, but a higher anointing in the person of the Holy Ghost will be his. At this time, Mr. Elder-elect Red, would you kneel before God?
Dear God, our Heavenly Father, we pray tonight that you would use our hands to touch and pour the anointing into the lives, especially anointing, hallelujah, for this particular office, for this particular position, into the heart and soul of this our brother. Oh God, we pray that the Spirit of the Lord will dominate only from this day forward in a very special way. Let your breath to pass that which you would have accomplished in his ministry. We pray, dear God, that he's becoming part of a team which he did not before, with which he did not before operate. But he shall be someone in this team, in this ministry, that will bring glory and honor to your name. We commit him now to you, Lord, in a very special way, for this very special ministry, under this special anointing. Remove our hands, Lord, let your hand all you give up, both now and forever, in Jesus' name.
Thank you.
which in biblical days was indicative of the priest. In addition to that cassock, the robe that is worn, a stole was placed upon the shoulders of the servant, which you stand. Two suffering bishops, Schofield and Cash, will now place this stole upon your shoulders. It is symbolic of the burden that you bear, the burden of God's people, the burden of responsibility, the burden of compassion, the burden of servitude. When you wear this priest garment, you approach God as an intercessor on behalf of those whom you serve. The burden that you carry will be a burden that will be a blessing. The Lord spoke and said, my burden, my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. If one is to come after the Lord, be his disciple, he has to carry a burden. I have great anticipation of the service that you will be able to render to the Lord in this office of District Governor. I anticipate that those churches whom you serve will be elevated to a new level because of the God that works in you. District Elder Mark Reed, I would ask that you, Sister Reed, as you stand with your husband in support and prayer. There will be times when the burden that he bears is so heavy that it will bring him to his knees. But that's the place where God will strengthen him. That is the place, as you knelt with him at this time, that you share that burden that God gives him in godly support to the man of God. God bless you. I present to you, thank you, suffering bishops. I present to you, you will turn with Jesus' joy, District Elder Mark Anthony.